Hi, this is a quick summary of everything I added to 40 Tours over time, including the newest update, which focuses on often requested features. I added the regular Star Polychora, including my personal favorite, the Great Grand Stellated 120 cell. Star polygons can be made by extending the edges of polygons until they meet outside of the polygon. This process of extending edges in 2D, faces in 3D, or cells in 4D is called stellation. One interesting thing about 4D space is that you can make fair dice with any number of sides. What makes a die fair is that every one of its faces is the same shape. In 3D, there are a limited number of shapes that have this property, but in 4D, there is a family of shapes called Gyrochora that can have any number of faces. But note that just like a 3D object has faces which are 2D shapes, a 4D object has faces which are 3D shapes, which we call cells. I added the ability to export meshes for 3D printing. I added a button that creates an anti-gravity field that makes objects float. One reason this is fun is that many 4D rotations cannot happen if the objects are touching the ground, and so it's cool to see the shapes spin more freely while they're in the air. I added line projections. It's an old-school and very mathy way of displaying 4D objects, which you may have seen before. The 2D projection helps understand what's going on. Basically, the lines are always projected onto the visible slice, no matter how far the objects are. You can also project the 2D faces. This was an often requested feature. Projections are useful to roughly see where there are 4D objects, but it's very easy for the projections to overlap a lot. I've had an even cooler version of that in Megakure since the beginning, and which will show up in 4D toys at some point. I added wireframe versions of certain shapes. This is similar to the shapes I made that were inspired by these Davinci drawings, but it is the 1D version instead of the 2D version. Because these objects are 4D, there are two ways to carve them instead of one. We can keep the 2D faces or the 1D lines. I don't want to spoil it, but it looks cool when you turn on the 2D face projection. I added Klein bottles, made a whole video about them, and even added a true 4D generalization of the Klein bottle. In the newest update, there is also a static Klein bottle with a sphere that you can roll inside. This allows to get a better feel for what inside a Klein bottle even means. I added scenes with a 120 cell and a sphere. I added scenes with tesseracts that are fixed at a point but with a torque that keeps them rotating. This includes a couple of scenes with a double rotation, two perpendicular planes of rotation at the same time. In four or more dimensions, an object can rotate in more than a single plane at the same time. It's fun to stop one rotation while the other keeps happening. I made these scenes where you can play with marbles that roll around on interesting terrain shapes. They took very little time to make because of the 4D procedural mesh generation systems I built. I think the most fun part is seeing the shapes shrink and disappear, then reappear and grow, while they roll down a path that curves in the fourth dimension. It's also neat to see them move on the projection, then reappear inside your visible slice. I added an auto-follow button that, when active, always moves your slice to the position of the last shape you touched. It's fun to use on marble scenes to follow a marble around at a weird slice orientation. And finally, yes, another very requested feature, the ability to rotate the 3D slice you are seeing. The 2D-3D version shows what it looks like to rotate a 2D slice of a 3D world. However, in 4D, there are more ways to rotate a 3D slice of a 4D world. The fun part was coming up with a simple interface. If you just rotate the 3D slice around the camera, you might make the level completely invisible because it doesn't belong to your slice anymore, or at best is off to the side in 3D. My goal was to design the interface to let players focus on the cool 4D stuff instead of the camera and slice position and orientation. As you can see, there is still no need to move the camera around the level, as the level is always in front of you no matter how you rotate in 4D. The three colored lines represent the three horizontal dimensions. You can trade which of these dimensions you can see by using the controller on the right. For example, this level is sloped, and you can either see the slope, but not the fourth dimension, or you can see the fourth dimension, but not the dimension that slopes down. So it looks like the level is flat here, but it's just that you cannot see the slope. The 2D-3D mode helps understand what that means, but you can also just play around with it. 4D Toys is all about playing with 4D in a high-bandwidth, undirected way, while Miyagakure uses a complementary approach to explaining the fourth dimension as one giant, detailed, and subtle tutorial. And as usual, everything I've shown here is available in VR, iOS, and mouse and keyboard, as well as in 2D 3D modes. I also made a Patreon where I give monthly updates on Miigakure 4D toys and whatever I'm working on.